We heard about this new panel of biomarker, the CKD273 today. It's certainly a very interesting marker, which has, I believe, the potential of predicting those patients who will progress towards kidney disease earlier than albuminuria. If we are able to identify those patients that progress for kidney disease, we can intervene earlier and preserve the renal function or delay the progression of the renal function decline and prevent dialysis, which is a endpoint which where we don't want to arrive. The CKD273 it might have the potential to pick up earlier patients. I probably need further development in the future of biotechnology to make the measurement of these or other markers accessible to primary care physicians, for example, at a reasonable price. And so that's a challenge, but we've moved so far with other technologies in diabetes, and I'm sure in the future there will be a possibility to have techniques and tools to measure this marker and this pool of markers and others in a quick and reasonably cheap way, so we can use them in clinic every day. I think the study was asking two questions, and certainly we have the impression of that the CKD273 predicts occurrence of microalbuminuria. The addition of losartan on top of RAS inhibition, but 80% of the patients were treated with RAS inhibitors, possibly has muddled the water a little bit. Two questions in one study might have complicated the readout of the other questions. And I'm sure future studies will definitely confirm the role of this new marker. Personally, I would not add two inhibitor of the RAS cascade. And as we have seen in this study, there was an increase in hyperkalemia, which we actually have to avoid. So safety is paramount. But certainly is a good start, and it opens many questions and more studies, and certainly I see a future for this new marker and new technologies for the future for earlier prevention in diabetes and kidney disease. You're asking the question at the moment, I think. We don't have the renal data yet, but I believe what we've seen in CREDENCE for canagliflozin is probably a class effect across all of them. And if we look at the new European Cardiology Association guidelines in conjunction with the ESD, we see that in patients at risk, SGLT2 inhibitor or GLP-1 agonists are first line before metformin. I will honestly put metformin together. And so you see that cardiologists are really much more aggressive, and these drugs save lives. Forget the kidney, they save hearts and cardiovascular mortality. And usually we know the hearts and kidney go together. So likely that, as the initial data are showing, a positive for both heart and the kidney. So really, the earlier the better, I would say.